It's always satisfying to transform objects with the addition of color and pattern, and in today's video, I'll show you how to do that with Marabu's Easy Marble, which is suitable for use on a variety of surfaces. There are a few things to know about Easy Marble before I get started. I want to talk to you about these characteristics because knowing them is going to help you get better results. So the first thing is that Easy Marble is a solvent-based product. That's why it sits on the water, and you'll see this when I start dropping the product on the water rather than mixing in with it. You'll see a lot of people work with gloves when they work with Easy Marble. I'm not going to. There is a little bit of an odor, so you might want to circulate the air around if you find that bothers you. There are 22 open stock colors, and included in that bottle is a sort of a dropper top, and though it's not an eyedropper style, you'll see me turn it over and shake, and that's what's going to get the drops to fall out of the bottle. That's going to allow you some control about how much you put on your water. When it comes time to choose the container that you're going to work in, the size of the container should very closely match the size of the thing that you're working on, whether it's paper like you see here or something else. Easy Marble is a great product. It'll work on glass and paper and plastic and metal and styrofoam and paper mache. So obviously when you start talking about three-dimensional products, you might have to think about a container that's deep enough to hold whatever the thing is you're going to dunk into the Easy Marble. When you start to work with the product, the first thing that you'll notice is that the open time is reasonably short. You have probably no more than 2.5 to 3 minutes to work. The solvent-based nature of this product means it's going to evaporate and dry pretty quickly. And you'll see, if you go beyond that 2.5 to 3 minutes, you'll see a skin start to form where the color or the product starts to skin over and dry. You're going to start losing the ability to get that to adhere to much more than probably anything than paper at that point. So keep that 2.5 to 3 minute window in mind. And I'm going to show you how you can put your first layer of color on over the entire surface of the water, which is going to allow you that open time so that you can monkey around with it and work. I'm also going to show you how you can stir the color up to get things that look like this. Or you can just leave the color more or less sitting on the surface. If you want larger open areas like this, then there's certainly ways to achieve both of those things. I've chosen 5 colors of Easy Marble. I have my container of water. I'm going to work on a 6x9 piece of paper, so this is a reasonably good sized tub for that. And you can see that the only other thing I've got here are some toothpicks. That's what I'm going to use to stir the color around with. So I'm going to pick these all up and I'm going to give them a shake. You don't have to shake them forever, but you do want to shake them a little bit. And you'll notice when you first get yours that the color might have seemed to have settled in the bottom. That's perfectly normal from standing or sitting or whatever. So when I start to take the covers off, I'm actually going to take them all off at once so I'm ready to go when I am ready to start putting color in. They'll all be in a state where I can just start dropping them in. And you'll see that there's that kind of dropper style thing built into the top of the bottle, and that's what's going to allow me to get a little bit of color at once. So I've got some 140-pound watercolor paper, and that's what I'm going to print on. That's what you saw a moment ago when I had those two pieces laid out and then brought the third one in. So what's important to keep that open time available as long as possible, you'll want to start with room temperature water. You don't want it ice cold. And you'll want to get your first color so that it covers almost the entire surface. And then you'll start adding your other colors. And if you want to mix it up, if you want to make marks, or if you want to change the look so it goes from something that would produce a look like this to something like this or like this, that's where the toothpick is going to come in. So let's start with, I think for my base color, I'm going to use, this is aqua green. So I'm going to shake this, and you can see that I've got green over the entire surface. That's important. That's going to give me that open time. Now I'm just going to shake some other colors in randomly. You can pattern, absolutely you can, but I'm just going random for now because I want to just show you the basic process. Now you'll notice that these colors are not mixing, so I've got aqua and I've got orange, and I'm not making mud because the colors don't mix. So I've got this pattern out here, and all I'm going to do is print what you see. I'm going to lay my piece of paper in there. I want to press a little bit so that I'm certain. Oftentimes what I find, if I'm not careful, this center piece right here doesn't actually touch the Easy Marble, and then I don't get coverage on there. I like to use a pair of tweezers, so I'm just going to come in on a corner. I'm just going to kind of break off what's on there And you can see you get this really interesting patterning. So something like this gives you big areas if you want to doodle in there. It gives you really large areas to do that. Or conversely, you can mix the colors up or you can move them around to get a more traditional marbled look. So I'm going to just take a piece of paper and I'm going to clear what's in here off, because it's already started to skin over in this period of time, and by the time I'm ready to actually start putting the next colors on, it will definitely have skinned over. Now, you don't have to do this. If you just want to keep working and working and throwing colors on your existing water bath, you can certainly do that. I think adhesion is simpler on paper, but if you're working on metal or plastic, you definitely don't want the product to be skinned over. So let's add some of a darker turquoise, and I think I'm going to make that my base color. So I'm going to put that one in enough so I have color all over the place, and you'll see that the color is moving around. Now there are some areas in here where I clearly did not pick up all of the color the last time, so you'll want to bear that in mind as you play around. Let's come in with some silver, and I think I'm going to stick to just these three colors for this. Now what I'm going to do is grab my handy dandy toothpick, and I'm just going to start moving the toothpick through the color so I get that, what you kind of consider that traditional marble look. Now I can leave it at this if I want, or I can come in and I can start moving it a little bit more elaborately, but bearing in mind that I have a fairly narrow window of time to work in. That glop that you see, that's perfectly normal, don't sweat it. That's just going to happen. So now I'm going to take my next piece of paper, I'm going to drop it in there. Make sure I tap in the center so I've got good adhesion and I get contact in there. And then I'm just going to grab... Actually, you know what I can do? If I want to do that and press it all the way down, I can kind of put some color on the back. And then I can pick this up. And how awesome is that? You get that wonderful patterning in there that is basically effortless. With Easy Marble being suitable for so many surfaces, it really opens up your creativity. So here I have several different things. These are from the Frank Morrow U-Paint product line. These are the big metal stampings. This is an angelfish, and this is this awesome dimensional spider. This is a Finibar Mechanical, and you'll notice that there's patterns on here. Just like I said in the last segment, where you can stir the color around, you can put those patterns in there, you can pick all of that up on something like a piece of metal. In fact, you can even see it here. It's a little bit obvious that there's patterning going on there as well. And then on the spider, I just went for sort of big areas. I wasn't too concerned, but you can see that there's definitely stripes and patterning that happen on the legs. So I've switched to a smaller container because I'm going to work on metal. Let me bring that in. I have a fresh batch of water. This time I'm going to use some warm colors along with turquoise. So I have orange and I have medium yellow. I'm going to give them a shake. I'm going to show you. So these, when they come, they have probably some machine oil on them from the manufacturing process. It's always a good idea to clean that off, that makes certain that the surface you're working with, whether it's metal or it's plastic or it's acrylic, is clean and free of dirt and debris and oils from anything, because that's going to get in the way of the product adhering. So I've got my products all shaken up here. Let me take the caps off. And I think this time I'm going to start with a base of yellow, which seems kind of good for a spider. I've got yellow now covering my entire surface. So in is going to come some of the orange, and then I'm going to drop in some of the turquoise. And then I'm going to move it around so I get some patterning in it. That I think I could have a little bit more, so I'm going to spend the time to do this. I'm going to put my toothpick out of the way, and I think I'm going to grab this. So I'm going to start by laying the legs in and then moving across and laying the body in, and then as this comes out of the water, I don't know if I caught that, so I'm just going to set it back in there. Oh, how awesome is that? Let me just catch that leg. Now I'm handling this more than I probably should. But holy moly, how cool is that? Look at the colors on that spider. Isn't that amazing? So once this is dry, and dry time for Easy Marble is about 20 minutes, dry to the touch. Full hardening takes probably 24 hours or a little bit more, and then you can handle it without any difficulty. But this is still wet, obviously, from the water, and it only has had a minute to do its thing. But this is just amazing to me. It just enthralls me. It's so interesting to see the things that you can do with it. So let's come in again, because I'm working with metal. I'm going to come in and just clean this off. remove the bulk of this color from the surface of the water. Get that out of the way, and I'm going to come back with similar colors, but this time, so I've got, this is one of the Barn Stars from the Finnebert collection, one of her mechanicals, and this is another one of the butterflies, although that one is missing an antenna, so let's come back to this one. I think what I'm going to do is bend this up like this, and then kind of curve the wings a little bit. I'm going to do that before I add the color, and then with the Barn Star, I'm going to see if I can do them both at the same time. So this time, I think I'm going to go for turquoise as my base color. I might add some of the orange and some of the yellow, and then I'm going to stir it up the same way that I did the last time with a toothpick. This time I'm going to go pretty close because the areas I'm working on, or the pieces I'm working on, are pretty small. So I want to get enough patterning in there that it actually appears on the piece. Get that out of the way. So in comes, I'm going to grab my tweezers. I think that's going to make life easier here. So I'm going to just set this down like that. Oh, awesome. And now I'm going to grab the Barn Star. And I think I'm actually just going to drop it through the product like that into the bottom, and then let me scoop it out so we can see what it looks like. Oh, see, how interesting is that? So let's get the water out of the way. So obviously the base color is what you see the most of. That's the one that you're going to lay down on the surface first, whether you go with orange like I did here, or I went with the turquoise here. So, as I said in the beginning, lots of different surfaces, from paper to plastic to metal to glass to kind of everything in between, and with all of these colors, and your ability to work with this product because you know the characteristics, you can do lots of really awesome things.